Good morning, children. So today's lesson, English for class 8. And look at that, children at work. Very interesting story, children. So we are going to do that lesson today.
So let's start a new chapter now. Do you know which chapter? Yes, Children at Work. From the book, It So Happened for class 8. Now, before we begin, I want to ask you something, or rather tell you something. There are many reasons why children have to work. Children means under the age of 18, that is below 18. Some help their family make a livelihood. Now, there are some very poor people, you know, their earning is not that good. So small children of that house are sent to work, they earn a little money and they bring home. Others who run away from unhappy homes need to support themselves. Now, some children, because of unhappy homes, they run away from their own home, and then obviously they have to support themselves. They need clothes, they need food for themselves. Yes, children who have to work can't go to school. Yes, you cannot do both things at the same time, going to school as well as do some work. No, not possible. Either you work or you go to school and play after that. So this is a problem. Child labor. I think you are very much familiar with child labor. Why does that happen? Because they start earning to make a livelihood. Why? To help their family members. Yes. So now let's have a look at the introduction. Velu was an 11-year-old boy. He had to run away from home. He got into a railway train without a ticket. He had to do so because he had no money. He escaped the ticket collector's notice because he did not come to that unreserved compartment. Now, so this is the story of Velu. He was how old? 11-year-old. He ran away from his home. Okay, then what happened? He got into a railway train, and that too without a ticket. Why without a ticket? Because he had no money to buy a ticket. And somehow he managed to escape the ticket collector's notice. Okay, actually that is wrong. But poor boy, he had no option but to travel without a ticket, since he had no money with him. Yes. Okay. So, Velu on the platform. He got off the train at Chennai Central. So, where did he get down? Which platform? Chennai Central. His legs were unsteady. What does unsteady mean? They were shaking, moving, as if he was still standing in a moving train. Children, do you know the reason for this? Because the first time he traveled in a train, you know, and after getting down the train also, he thought his legs are still shaking, moving, and that he's still in the train. It was because of, and it happens to us also sometimes when we're too much tired. It happens because of weakness, tiredness, and fear. It happens because of fear. Our legs start trembling, shaking, isn't it? Yes, the crowds and the way, people looked upon him made him miserable. Everybody was staring at him. He sat on a bench on the platform. You must have seen what is the condition of a platform, you know. And for the people to sit, there are benches there. People sit on that, take rest, wait for their train and all that. So he sat on a bench on the platform with his small bundle beside him. He was carrying a bundle. Yes, he was very hungry. For 2 days he had eaten nothing but some peanuts and a piece of jaggery. Children, you say shenga shenga? That's what, peanuts. Okay. Next is what, you know, you can see there the subheading, what? Velu meets Jaya. Suddenly he heard a rough voice calling him. Somebody was calling him. He saw a girl around his age. She was wearing a very long banyan. Velu started at her, stared at her vacantly because he doesn't know her, who she is. Then she asked his name. She guessed rightly that Velu had run away from home. See, the girl was clever, na? She was able to guess that Velu has run away from his home secretly. She told him that he won't get food sitting there. So that's what Velu told. Yes, the girl was a rag picker. She used to pick rags. She picked her sack and moved away. Generally, you must have seen, what do the rag pickers do? They carry a big sack with them, and in that they put all the small bits of dirty newspapers and other things in that. That's why it's called rag, you know. Velu thought she was his only hope, so he followed her. Okay, Velu thought she was his only hope, so he followed her. Okay. So children, see, what do we see here in this story so far? See, now Velu ran away from his home. Yes, we have come across that. Now, do you think simply he ran away? No. You know, I guess he must have faced lot of troubles, problems at home, or bad behavior from some of his family members or one of his family members. So every day the same thing continues, bad behavior, harsh treatment. One will be fed up. Yes. So some similar thing happened to Velu. So he was such a small boy. Otherwise, why should he run away from his home? And that too, he had no money with him. It's actually very difficult, isn't it? See, and the girl, this girl here in the story, rag picker. Summary of part 2. So let's begin. Velu didn't know English. Yeah, because he did not go to school. Yes, Velu caught up with the girl, that small girl. He started walking very fast to catch up with him. The two came on the road. The girl helped him cross the road with her. They walked along the side of the road. So now both have started walking together. Where? Along the side of the road, because it is safer to walk there. There were huge signboards above them. You know, in big cities, wherever you go, every road, there are big signboards. Most of them are advertisements and all that. And such things Velu is seeing for the first time in his life. Okay. The writing was all in English and he doesn't know. Velu understood nothing. Poor fellow, he has never gone to school. This showed that he did not know English, because he must be staring at those big signboards. He doesn't know how to read. That's the reason. Central Jail. They walked for a long time. The girl pointed to the one building with the wall around it. Velu read the Tamil sign on it. What was written there? It was Central Jail. The girl laughed. She told him to be careful if he wanted not to be inside that jail. That means what? He should not do anything wrong. Velu said he hadn't done any wrong. The girl said that it didn't matter. The important thing was he shouldn't be caught. Yes, that was very important. He should not be caught. Yes, otherwise he'll be put behind the bars. The garbage bin. Let's see what's it all about. After about an hour's walk, what is happening? Let us see. They stopped in front of a big building. What's that building? The sign on the building read, Sri Raj Rajeshwari Prasanna Kalyana Mandapam. Velu read it as it was in Tamil, like the sign on the central jail. Because it was in Tamil, he read it. Velu looked at the huge hall and the crowds of people inside. He asked what? Let's see, what did he ask? Can you guess what did he ask? Yes. So he asked the girl if they were going to eat there. The girl ridiculed him, started scolding, making fun of him. Then she led him to a garbage bin behind the hall. The food, that is, they can eat from there. The girl picked up a crushed banana and offered it to Velu to eat. Imagine a crushed banana. It must have looked so dirty also. Velu was shocked. He asked if they were going to eat the leftovers. All the leftovers were thrown in the bin. Yes, the girl disagreed. She said no. She said that she ate only untouched food. She said, no, I eat only untouched food. So what did she do? She threw him a vada. Velu looked at it with distaste because it is all leftover. He does not want to eat that. Yes. However, he was too hungry to refuse any food. But imagine his condition. He was so hungry that in that condition, he cannot refuse also. He cannot say, no, I am not going to eat. Yes. So he ate the banana as well as the vada. He ate that. Banana also he ate, vada also he ate. The girl could find only one more banana, which she ate herself. See how kind the girl is. She eats only one banana, but she tells Velu, you eat the banana as well as the vada also. Good girl. Now the girl's work. Now it is about the girl's work. This girl's name was Jaya. So what's that little girl's name? Jaya. She picked up a couple of bottles from the heap. She said she had to do her work. She's a rag picker. So, seeing her going, Velu panicked. He followed her. Let's continue in the next video. Okay, children. So, what will we do? We'll continue the next video. But before that, you know what? What you should do? You should read this. So, what is it about? What did you understand in this part? What did you understand? That Velu doesn't know which language? Yes. Velu doesn't know English. He knows only, which language does he know? Only Tamil. So all the signboards in Chennai, that big city, the big signboards. Was he able to read the signboards? No, he was surprised to see such big signboards. Why? It was the first time he was seeing such big signboards. And you remember, he had no opportunity to go to school. He was made to earn livelihood. Father was very harsh to him. Okay, that is the reason actually. It is there in the lesson, but I am telling you now. So, and what is your idea about that little girl Jaya? She is very intelligent. And what else? Any other adjectives? She is very smart. After reading this part, what do you feel? She has no fear in her mind. She is very, she is without any fear. Fearless girl. And in fact, as you have seen here in this part, she leads Velu everywhere. And she's such a nice girl. She helps Velu. She gives him more food. She consumes only one banana. But what does she do? She's so kind. She gives Velu one banana as well as one vada. Does she eat vada? No, she doesn't eat. She's so thoughtful, so kind. She thinks about Velu first. So, though Velu did not want to eat. Why? Because it is all leftover food. Perhaps some marriage or some party must have been there in that hall. Yes. So because, see, nobody has the habit of eating any leftover. Velu may be from a very poor background. That doesn't mean that he will eat all the leftovers which is thrown here and there and that too in the bin. Can anybody do that? No. Yes. So Velu actually did not want to eat, but since there was no other option open for him, there was no other go, so he had to eat that. The girl's home. Whose home? You remember? There's a girl in this story. Who's that girl? Jaya. They walked on for half an hour. Who are they walking? Yes, Jaya and that boy, small boy who ran away from his house. What's his name? Velu. Yes. They came to a bridge across a dirty trickle of water. Trickle. Now, when water falls very slowly in drops, as we say drop by drop, that is called trickle. Dirty. The water must have been dirty. So, dirty trickle of water. Jaya called it Buckingham Canal. So what name does she call that canal, that water, trickle of water, Buckingham Canal? Near some puddles of water, there was a row of huts. In a line, many huts were there. That is called a row of huts. Puddles of water. Do you know what is puddles of water? Now, you must have come across Now suppose there's a road and the roads are in a very bad shape. The roads are broken here and there, the holes. And when it rains, all the water goes and accumulates there. Then what does it become? Puddles of water. These were the strangest huts Velu had ever seen. So Velu is seeing these huts for the first time. That's the reason he finds these huts very, very strange. Now, they were made of all sorts of things like metal sheets, tires, bricks, wood and plastic. Yes, you know, poor people, they cannot afford to make their houses from bricks and cement and all that. Okay, so what do? They use tires and bricks for their shelter. They stood crookedly and looked as if they would fall at any moment. It is something like, you know, what you say, temporary hut, we can say that. To Velu, these huts look strange because in his village, the houses were made of mud and palm leaves. Yes, in his village, the houses were made of mud and palm leaves. That is the upper part, you know, they put palm leaves. That is the roof. Now, Velu becomes a rag picker because he is with Jaya, who's already a rag picker. Jaya dumped her sack outside a hut. Then she picked up an empty sack. Okay, so an empty one. Now, what is a sack? You must have seen a rag picker carrying that longish type of thing. That is a sack. She gave Velu a pair of old shoes without laces. She handed him a sack and stick also, because these are the things which a rag picker generally carries with him or her. Velu was confused. He was not able to understand what was happening. He has never done the work of a rag picker earlier. Then Jaya explained that she was a rag picker. Jaya told him that she was a rag picker. That was her livelihood. This was the only work she could give to Velu if he wanted any. So she tells Velu that she doesn't know any other work, and to Velu she can give only this work, the work of a rag picker. Children like her collected paper, plastic, glass, etc. Now, I have myself seen so many times rag pickers picking up all these things. You must have also seen. And what do they do with these things? Do you know, once their sack is full, they go and sell it in a shop, and that man pays these rag pickers very little amount of money. They earn very little. Very difficult to survive on that little amount of money. But there's no other option. This was the only work she could give to Velu if he wanted. Okay, now, so they collected all these papers, plastics, glass and all that. And what did they do? They sold these things to Jaggu of Jam Bazaar, or Jam Bazaar, what do you say? Jaggu is the name of a person. He's from that Jam Bazaar. So Jaggu sells them. He in turn goes and sells all these things where? To a factory. So it is like that. That is what the rag pickers, I mean, that is how they earn their money. But very little they earn. This time Velu hesitated. Actually, he was not willing to do that one. That is what hesitated means. He hadn't come to Chennai to dig through garbage. He did not come to Chennai to collect all the garbage. Sorry. However, he felt he must do it until he finds a better job. But there was no other option. So he understood that that is the only job he has to do as of now, because he doesn't know anyone there. There's no other job. And he needs money for food and all that. Yes. So he decided to follow her with a sigh. Children, do you know what is S-I-G-S, sigh? When we do like this, that is called sigh, you know. When we are quite sad about something, then what do? We sigh. That is called sighing. Okay, now children, see, this is very interesting. interesting why it is a story of two children. They go to an unknown place, unknown city, unknown state, and especially Velu. He's so surprised, shocked, everything. He has got mixed reactions, you know.
That's all for this session. Thank you, children.